a custom stinger transition is a great way to be able to keep your viewers entertained when you're switching scenes inside of Streamlabs. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how you can go ahead and add a custom stinger transition. That way you can improve the look and feel of your stream, keep your viewers engaged, but most importantly, make your stream look professional. So let's go ahead and dive right into it. So once you go ahead and have Streamlabs open, what you're going to want to do is under scenes, you're going to want to select this little gear icon. You're then going to select add transition. You can go ahead and label this what you like. I'm going to leave it as new transition. Then for the type, you want to select stinger. Then this is going to give us the option to be able to upload our video file for our stinger. Now, if you don't have a custom stinger transition, you can go to streamdesigns.com and I'll put a link in the description where you're going to be able to get stinger transition and other overlays to make your stream look professional. So once you go ahead and have your file, you're gonna select browse, and I'm gonna go ahead and utilize the Stinger Transition Tron from Stream Designs for this example. So I'll select open, and now we hit done. Hit done, and you can see here that now when I transition, you're gonna see that there's nothing that happens, right? But why? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select this little gear icon. I'm gonna make sure I have the stinger transition selected, hit done, and then when I switch over, you can see here that you saw the scene prior to the stinger transition occurring. So to be able to fix that, we're gonna select this little gear icon, you're gonna select the little edit, and this is where we're gonna want to adjust the transition point. So what I found the sweet spot to be is about 1500, and then you can go ahead and tweak it based on what you see. Then for the audio fade style, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to select cross fade. This is going to be very important because what this allows you to do is that when you switch scenes, your audio is not going in and out. That way your viewers don't have a bad experience. Then you select done, make sure it's selected, hit done, and now you can see here that when we switch scenes, the transition happens first and then the scene appears, and that's the kind of experience that you're going to want to go ahead and have. And just like that, you can see that now you have a nice animation that looks professional, that's going to keep your viewers entertained when you're switching scenes. But if you want to learn how to go ahead and add other overlays like countdown timers, alerts, go ahead and watch this video right here where I take you step by step on adding your overlays inside of Streamlabs, and I even give you access to a free stream overlay package from Streamdesigns that you can go ahead and utilize completely for free. I'll see you in the next video.